Welcome back, students. In this particular video of JEE Mains Crash Course type of course, over here what we are doing, we are picking some good and you can say conceptual problems from different topics. We are putting them together and then we are discussing those problems with you. Fine. It's like that in number of like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I mean keep on moving the entire set in this manner. Fine. Now, in this particular question, we want to analyze our basic understanding of you can say the concept of velocity and how to find out if two components of the velocity are given, then how to find the velocity and finally the distance. Fine. So, as such the question is of you can say moderate type. I'm not going to say like it as a easy type, moderate, easy to moderate type. So, what exactly the question is? Question is a point, maybe an insect or something, moves in xy plane. So, two dimensional motion is going to be there. According to the law, x is equal to 4 sine 60, not law, basically equation. So, I mentioned it like this, and y is equal to 4 within bracket 1 minus cos 60. Now, the distance traveled by the particle in 4 seconds is how much? So, from here, let me allow to translate few terms of the question. So, one part is along x direction, the displacement or you can say motion is governed by this equation, and along y direction, if you just take a look over here, it is 4 minus 4 cos 60. Fine. Now, take a look of these equations and this is the question. Over here now, I am going to provide you the solution. So, from here, we can get x prime or vx means velocity along x direction. First listen, then I will solve it. And from here you can get the velocity along y direction. So, what exactly we are interested for? From here it is x prime and from here it is y prime. Fine. So, let us try to find out these values. So, first is x prime r Vx, very fundamental thing. So, what it will give you? It will give you this 4 sine 60. So, you will get it as that is 4 into 6 sine 66 and then sine of this cos. So, it is going to be what? It is going to be 24 cos 60. Similarly, the y component that is y prime or Vy is equal to, take a look, this 4 is meaningless for me. So, it is going to be 6 4 ja 24 cos minus sine 60. So, this will give me plus 24 sine 60. Fine. Now, from here we can find the velocity V is equal to under root Vx square plus Vy square. Fine. Now, let me allow to put the values over here. So, sine square 60 plus cos square 60 will give you 1. 24 square take out common. So, ultimately it is 24 meter per second. That is the velocity. Now, you have to find the distance traveled by the particle in 4 seconds. So, distance x is equal to x. Okay, fine, no problem. I think I should mention it as d because x may be confusing from this point. So, d is equal to vt. So, 24 into 4 is equal to how much? It is going to be 96 units. Take a look. So, from here, what I can say, I request you please shift from here to here. So, you can say option A is the correct option for this particular question. Fine. I started with a very simple question because you don't know when and how in the actual examination a simple question can come. In year 2018, JEE Mains exam, in one paper, there was a question associated with the color coding and value. What you have to do, you need not to apply any formula. Just remember the value. Red, green, brown, yellow, that B.B. Roy formula. So, can you imagine this type of question is also asked? Maximum number of students left that question because they were not able to recall those values. Let's take a look of this question. Fine. The seconds hand of watch. Well, if you take a look of your wall clock or wrist watch, you will find there are three hands. One is hour, one is minute, and one is second. So, this question is associated with seconds, means third hand. So, the seconds hand of watch has length 60 centimeter. Fine. Speed of end point and magnitude of difference of velocities at two perpendicular positions will be how much? Now, this question is really very simple question. Imagine the speed of end points and magnitude of difference of velocities. Magnitude of difference of opposite, one is in this direction, another in this direction. Two vectors. So, one is in this direction, if plus, then it is going to be minus minus vector. So, ultimately it is going to be added over there. So, let's take a look of the solution of this particular question. Now, V is equal to R omega. Fine. Now, omega is what? That is V is equal to R pi by t. And what will be the time taken by this seconds hand in your wristwatch, if you take a look, to complete one round? So, you will say, sir, 60 seconds it will take. Fine, no problem. So, it is 6 centimeter. So, ultimately you have to find it like this, 60 into 2 pi upon 60. Fine. So, after putting this value, cancel out. So, V is equal to 2 pi. That is, fine. So, from here, delta V square plus V square minus 2 VV and cos of 90. Fine? Yes. So, when you solve it, you will get it as root 2 V. And what is the value of V? That is, sorry, it is small v. What is the value of V? It is 2 pi. So, ultimate answer, I would like to write down at this position from this and this, it is 2 root 2 pi meter, sorry, mm per second, because I changed it like this. You can do the calculation, 6 into 10 to the power minus 2 into 2 pi upon 60 also you can solve, ultimately you will get the same value. Fine. So, it is just a part of the calculation. Oh, sorry. I forgot to. Sorry, let's match the option. So, 2 root 2 pi, 2 root 2 pi. So, what exactly one answer is going to be? One answer is going to be 2 pi, fine. And another answer is 2 root 2 pi, 2 root 2 pi, that is this one. So, D is the correct answer, okay. Then it is question number third. A ball of mass m gram, m is 50, no problem, dropped from a height h is equal to 10 meters. Okay. It rebounds losing 75% of its kinetic energy if it remains in contact with the ground for a small time, delta t. The impulse of the impact force is how much? Now, this type of question is directly going to check your understanding. So, first let me allow to draw a diagram. Let's say it is the ground, and from here this distance is h 10 meters. Okay, let's mention it h initial. So when it falls, it strikes over here, rebound. H final, let's say. Now, 75% its kinetic energy is lost, means it will rebound only 1 by 4 of H initial. So let's move with this particular concept. Fine. H initial is equal to 10 meters. It is given in the problem itself. Fine. That is given. H final is equal to 75% loss, okay, 75% of its kinetic energy loss. So you can say H final is equal to 25 by 100 into 10. Can we do like this? Yes, yes, we can do like this. 4, it will give me what? That is 2.5 meters. Fine. So I think now I should mention only the values. So the value is going to be 2.5 meter. Ultimately, we have to find the impulse. Okay. So V initial is from this particular relation is going to be how much? 2GHI under root. And as such, G is not given. So let's take the value of G is equal to 10. So when I solve it, I will get the value as somehow 210, that is 20 into 10, 200, somehow 14.14 meter per second. 200 into 10, 20, yes, 200. And finally, V final is 2G. H final under root. So when we put the value 2 into 10 into 2.5, we will solve it 7.07 meter per second. I selected specifically these values. Fine. So let me allow to mention the values over here. So V initial is how much? 1 meter per second. And V final is how much? 7.07 meter per second. Now, let's erase it out. Finally, delta V is equal to, that is change in velocity is equal to V initial minus minus V final. Okay, so it will give you plus 7.07. How much it is going to be? 21.21 meter per second. Fine. This is the velocity. But you have to find the impulse. Okay. So impulse is delta P. Fine. That is change in momentum. This is impulse. Okay. So, impulse, just take a look, impulse delta P is equal to M delta V. And what is the value of this M? That is 50 into 10 to the power minus 3. So, when you will solve it, 0.6 Newton into meter. This is going to be your answer. Fine. So, ultimately, this is B is the correct option. Fine. The calculation is slightly, you can say, long. Otherwise, the question is very, very simple. Well, JEE Mains questions, they are not of very difficult category questions. Yes, up to some extent, you can say some sort of deeper thinking somewhere required. Otherwise, if you are well prepared from your entire course, you are going to go through with this exam very properly. Then it is question number 4. Now, this question also I tried to put in the category of this impulse, change in momentum and so on. I hope this will give you much better clarity of this particular concept. A force exerts an impulse I on a particle, changing its speed from u to u. So, in previous question, it was v initial, v final, that is type of thing. The applied force and the initial velocity are oppositely directed along the same line. Imagine, this is the catch line. The applied force and initial velocity are oppositely directed along the same line. The work done by the force is how much? So, the basic formula that comes in the mind fine. Now, obviously, this formula we are not going to use. So, some sort of changes are required for understanding of this particular formula which is going to be used over here. Now, impulse I is equal to delta P is equal to M delta V. I think I should write it down first. M delta V. Then from here, once again, I can write I is equal to delta P is equal to M into 3U. Fine? Or you can say, clear? Now, after writing this formula, what I can say, this and this. So, M is equal to I upon 3U. It is nothing but the change, or you can say some sort of makeup of this particular question. Then, if this formula is not giving you any idea, then from class 11th, we have one relation, that is work energy. Clear? M is this much, velocity changes given. So, W is equal to delta KE, this fine, delta KE, and it will give you half M, and U 4, that is how much it is given as 2U. So, it is going to be 2 to the 4 U square minus U square. Fine. So, how much it will be? It will be 3 U square. So, 3 by 2 out. M into U square. I hope it is right. Yes. Then put the value of M from this box in this relation and solve it. So, if I put the value over here, so W is equal to 3 by 2 into I by 3 U, yes, into U square. 3 by 2 U I by 3 cancel. So, how exactly it is going to be? It is going to be half I U. Fine. So, let us try to find out the solution, which one is going to be 1 by 2 I U, 1 by 2 I U, that is B is the correct option. So, this is the approach for this question. I would like to request all of you, please just take a look of this. I am out of your frame. Fine. So, from here you can say the solution is not so difficult, but yes, up to some extent some changes in steps are required. And over here one thing I want to mention, that in these type of questions they just want to check whether you are capable enough to imagine like some changes in the formula or not. Say for example, I use this M is equal to I upon 3U. Fine. So, in examination hall, if it is like that, it comes in your mind, it required some amount of practice before the actual exam. And we are just trying to provide you that essential practice. Okay. Let's go for question number 5. That is going to be your question from a variable mass system. Actually, this topic is very important. From your Newton's laws, conservation of linear momentum. So, there is one relation. I specifically want to mention this relation at this portion. Please take a look. That relation is associated with mv and d by dt. Fine. So, first time m dv by dt, it will give you what? That is second law, ma. But in rocket case, m also changes. Got the idea? Because as the gases ejected out, fuel filled in the rocket burn out, then mass of the rocket also reduces. I am sure you must have noticed it on TV. First stage channel has been dropped off polar GSLV vehicle, that is geostationary satellite launch vehicle like polar satellite, PSLV and so on. So, first stage drop, second stage. So, it is like that mass keeps on decreasing. Fine. So, that more velocity it can acquire. A rocket of mass this much, gases, fuel with entire, is set for vertical firing. Rocket always moves like this. How much gas must be ejected per second so that the rocket may have an initial upward acceleration of magnitude 19.6 meter per second square. Exhaust speed of fuel is 980 meter per second. Fine. Simple, you can say, database problem. Some data is given and you have to just put the data in the required format and get the solution. Fine. Sorry. So, ma barabar upward thrust minus weight. I hope this much is clear to all of you. So, from here what I can say, V relative, sorry, it is in suffix, V relative is equal to minus dm by dt. Fine, minus dm by dt. And weight is what? Obviously, mg. Fine. And this is going to be equal to what? This is going to be equal to ma. I hope terms are clear. Thrust is dm by dt, weight is mg, and this will give me the relative velocity, but which is going to be equal to ma. So, minus dm by dt. And don't get confused, this is just a conceptual part. Fine, for this relation over here, and because in this relation I use this value, that is why I am putting it. Minus dm by dt is equal to m g plus a, put it there. So, it is going to be with positive sign. So, minus dm by dt is this much and upon vr. Fine. Now, it is simple. After that, what you have to do, dm by dt 4000, fine, yes, 400, it is kilogram given over here, and then because it is 19.6980, so I think rather than taking the value of g as 10, take it 9.8, because then it is going to be cancelled, plus what is the acceleration? 19.6, yes, yes, this is correct decision. Upon what is the relative velocity? That is very good decision. You know why? Because this is something which is going to match with this number. So, after solving, fine. After solving, I will get it as 120 kg per second. So, this is the rate of burning of you can say fuel because the rate of burning of fuel and ejected gases are equal to each other. So this way, let me allow to move out 120, you just take a look of this much. So here C is your correct answer. Fine. Now let's move for next question, that is 6 number. A force F acts on a particle of mass m for 2 seconds. Okay, it's like this way. Okay, 1, 2, 3, somehow then force stops. If initial velocity of the particle is this much, speed of particle at the end of 2 seconds. So first you have to find out the velocity, and then magnitude of that velocity will give you the speed. Okay, so I hope the question is not so difficult. Work energy theorem type of thing also you can use. Let me allow to check how simply we can solve it. Impulse I is equal to delta P, that is actually in this particular video I devoted good amount of time on this very important concept, change in linear momentum. Okay, I is equal to delta P. So F impulse is what? Delta T. F delta T, this is for I, and that is going to be what? That is going to be M V final minus V initial. Yes. So from here V final minus V initial, let me allow to put the values. I think I just simply mention it like this. Putting the values, because putting the values and showing it, it is not so essential. So after solving, putting the values and solving, Vf is equal to 6 I cap, yes, plus 3 j cap plus 6 k cap. Fine. 2 and time is how much? 2 seconds. 2, 2 ja 4, 2, 3, 2 ja 6. Yes, that's correct. So it is going to be this much. Then V final is equal to 6, 6 ja 36, 3, 3 ja 9 plus 36. So it is 72, 81. And that will give me, 81 means V final is equal to 9 meter per second square. Very simple question. Only this cross product is slightly going to be time taking, just 10 to 20 seconds, not more than that. So here 9 meter C is the correct option for this particular question. Fine. So I think we should stop over here. Soon we'll come back again with some more good questions. Till then, keep revising, keep watching, take care of yourself.